Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding all that was discussed at Dodo written by RK Raghavan. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is very important for political science, public administration and sociology optional students. Plus this is also very important from your essay point of view. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about a recent conference that took place in Kutch between the DGPs of the state polices and the Prime Minister of India. This editorial is also about how there is a need to bring about a complete transformation, a complete revamping, a complete restructurization in the police setup. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we need to know something about police in India. Now, as far as police as a subject is concerned, it is basically a state subject. Now, when it is a state subject, center has got no power to intrude into the functionality of the police in the states. Center is just creating up the laws under which the police can function. The complete functionality, the complete control, the accountability and the responsibility of the police is directly to the state government. Now, why this conference was organized? This conference was organized in order to have a kind of opinion from the head of the state polices of how the policing is done in their states. This conference was done with an idea to interact with the head of the police of the states. But when you look at the role of the police, or when you look at the goal of the police, or when you look at the structurization of the police, that is all having a kind of a British inertia behind it. Currently, the police organization is not clear about its role, whether it is a preventive agency or it is an agency for investigation, or it is an agency to protect the people, or it is an agency under the hands of the state government to unleash the terror. So the police is actually not clear about its role. When it's not clear about its role, there comes the problem in its functionality. And when you look at the entire police structure, 85% of the police, it consists of the constabulary. And this constabulary constitutes a big chunk. Indian police structure is lacking in the middle officers. When it is lacking in the middle level officer, it creates a lot of problem in yielding accountability from such a large constabulary. Now this constabulary, it indulges in a lot of corruption, it indulges in red tapism, it indulges in nefarious activities, it indulges in a lot of aberrations which are actually not in conformity with the ethics that the police should exhibit. Now, what would we be getting out of this conference? So this is a big question. Now, as far as police is concerned, when it is not under the aegis of the central government, what the central government can do, it can just push the states to introduce with their specific police acts. Supreme Court, it has come out with a verdict in which it has asked the state governments to transform the police structurization. It has come out with a model police act. Now currently what the police faces is lot of corruption in the fora of appointment, in the fora of transfer, in the fora of administration, and there is lot of politicization of police, there is criminalization of police, and a nefarious nexus is winded up between the politicians, criminals and the police. And what needs to be done is to untie this Gordian knot. This Gordian knot can be untightened if the states will introduce the Model Act that the Supreme Court had time and again been exhorting the state governments to do. But the state governments, they want to create a kind of an intrusive atmosphere for the police. They don't want to give away their power with respect to transferring, and they don't want to introduce the security of tenure. Then apart from this, what else was discussed in the conference was making police a smart organization. Now, when we look at the kind of the crime that the society is witnessing and the transformation the entire world is going on because of the information technology, because of the communication technology, police has also to introduce this complete transformation. When you look at the weaponry that the police is having, still a lot of states are using 303 weaponry, and this 303 has been done away with in army and in paramilitary, but the state policemen, they are still using this. And another weapon that the state is using is SLR, self-loading rifle. Now this rifle, it's actually a very heavy rifle. It is not easy for a policeman to pick this rifle and to perform its daily functions. So what needs to be done is to allow the small, micro and medium enterprises to foray into this defense manufacturing thing, because the small, medium and micro units can help India to bridge the gap that it is currently facing with respect to the weaponry. Then apart from this weaponry and apart from the structurization, another thing that needs to be introduced into the police is a psychological, behavioral and the attitudinal change. Now the attitude and the behavior of the police is something that exhibits of the British inertia. We need to do away with that inertia. We need to do away with the denominator of hegemony, with the denominator of ascendancy, and with the denominator of calling itself a father of everybody. That can be done if there will be a kind of a psychological training. That can be done if the policemen would be provided with better facilities. That can be done if we will streamline the entire criminal justice system. Now, transformation in the police also requires a transformation in the judicial corridors. Now, when the cases are moving at a snail's speed, it becomes a kind of an excuse on the part of the police to proceed the things slowly. Police generally don't file the charge sheet in the cases for about 1 year, 2 years, and it end up prolonging maybe 3 years or 4 years in serious crimes. Now this prolonging of the filing of the charge sheet is entirely in the hands of the investigating officer. And these investigating officers, they take a lot of bribe in delaying the process or in making the process fast. Police has got a lot of freedom at the lower level. At the higher level, police is not having any freedom with respect to administration. There is lot of police interference. DGPs, they have got no power with respect to appointment of the personnel, with respect to appointment of the head of the polices at the district level and at the sub-district levels. Now all these levels are actually nothing but in the hands of the deputy CM, or in the hands of the home minister of the state, or in the hands of the CM of the state. And all these posts are actually not the administrative police posts, they are actually the political police posts. So lot is required to be done if we want to have a clean police. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire services, on entire civil services preparation. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is BrainyKey. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you've liked this video, do click on the like button. Do share and comment on this video. And do participate in the answer writing program. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice night.